There's been some conversation about banning businesses from mandating that employees get vaccinated. And I know that many people are frustrated that they don't want their employer telling them what to do. I hear you. And that's why I didn't order state employees to get vaccinated. In fact, I banned the state from instituting vaccine passports. Because of our respect for freedom, South Dakota's work ethic is second to none, and our business environment is second to none. Business freedom and individual freedom work together to make South Dakota's economy the strongest in the nation. Now, I have been vaccinated. More than 60% of eligible South Dakotans have been vaccinated against the virus, and I'd encourage every South Dakotan to choose to get vaccinated if you want to. But that's your choice, and it should be your choice. Government shouldn't be mandating it to you. That's why I will oppose President Biden's illegal vaccine mandates. I will take every action available under the law to protect South Dakotans from the federal government. South Dakota has not imposed any mandates. In fact, I was the only governor in America who never ordered a single business or church to close. And frankly, I don't think the businesses should be mandating that their employees be vaccinated either. And if they do mandate vaccines to their employees, they should be making religious and other exemptions available to them. But I don't have the authority as governor to tell them what to do. And since the start of this pandemic, I have remained focused on what my authorities are and what they are not. Now, South Dakota is in a strong position because I didn't overstep my authority. I didn't trample on the rights of our people, and I'm not going to start now. When leaders overstep their authority, that is how we break this country. And if government starts acting unconstitutionally, even if it's doing something that we like, that is a dangerous path to walk down. It will actually lead to the destruction of our Constitution and our nation. We must be a nation of laws, and government must be constrained by the Constitution. It is not conservative to grow government and to tell businesses what to do and how to treat their employees. Most of the Republican legislators in South Dakota, they get that, but there are a vocal few, like John Hansen and Scott Odenbach, who are chasing headlines and are trying to tell South Dakotans how to do business. They want to make government bigger and more powerful in your life. And it's like a wolf in sheep's clothing. Know this, that their proposal as written is not conservative. Making government bigger and giving it more power is not conservative. Some business leaders may make decisions that we disagree with, and that happens every single day. Businesses that choose to require vaccinations should do so with the full knowledge that their employees and their future workers, they may have other choices. And workers may be faced with a time when the requirements or values of their employer is inconsistent with their own beliefs. But bringing government into those decisions is not the solution. It won't solve the COVID-19 pandemic, and it won't solve the workforce shortage in our state, and it won't solve the challenges that businesses face. Now, my focus will always be this, ensuring that South Dakota remains a great place to live, to work, to raise a family, and to do business. And let me clarify this. Legislators can call themselves into session if they have support. They don't need me to do it. They just need support of their colleagues. Now, if I start telling South Dakotans how to do business, it will destroy the freedom that made our state so strong in the first place. And South Dakota is strong, and I love it with all my heart. You have a wonderful day.